What is happening, ladies and gents? I was just hanging out with a dead body. No big deal. Slaymate here, and we're playing more Kona. And I... Let's see, I think we were... Whoa, now. We're going to go down the left trail. Yeah, I think we went to the one across the street. Pretty sure. So yeah, I think we're going to go to the left across the bridge. Get our adventure on this way, I think. Yes. To where the good Dr. Bipro lives. Uh-oh. We're loading. Hopefully the bridge doesn't break. Western Atamipek. Okay. We're good. Should we drive up the steps? We'll let fate decide.
No!
Carl couldn't open the door. Because he was blocked by some logs. Dr. Bipro's clinic. Oh my god. Oh, I see. He's got a mailbox right next to his place. It's pretty sneaky.
There should be a law forbidding doctors from falling sick.
Medical emergency in town. The doctor there's sick. I'll be back soon. If he dies, I'll be returning. I'll have to replace him. Wow, but who's going to replace you here? That doesn't make sense.
In spite of Dr. Beaupré's goodwill, the place didn't look much like a physician's office. It could easily be mistaken for a sewing shop.
Where's the light switch? Like, if I was a light switch, I would be next to a door, right? Alright, I guess it's flashlight time. Beautiful. Isabel Bipro, his wife, dead. I'll brew up some tea with her ashes. That seems respectful. Attach a wire. I don't have another magnet. Why do I have a weird accent? I don't know. Let's turn that right off. Dang. What are you?
Carl got the trembles as he imagined the excruciating pain that kind of scalpel could no doubt inflict.
What?
Within these miserable walls, patients probably felt more like in a slaughterhouse than in a doctor's office.
What? Why? They look clean and nice. It's just a scalpel, dude. I think Carl might have some, like, underlying hidden issues or something. How much do you weigh? My nightmare. Yeah, it's most people's nightmare, getting weighed. The doctor's apparently fascinated by history. Earth doesn't look this big from here. What? I think Carl might have an issue. Store in a cool with a consistent temperature, they said. Alright. Just gonna pretend that the doctor gives his patients wine as an anesthetic before he goes to work on them, apparently.
Like a slaughterhouse.
A chamber pot. Fortunately for Carl, inspecting it wouldn't further this particular investigation.
How do you know unless you investigate it further and or take a sip out of it in order to see who's been here?
A communist manifesto. Only a few years ago, this type of allegiance meant prison time. And even at present, the Western world was very wary of the Soviet threat. Why would the doctor own such a book?
The history of all hitherto existing society is the history of class struggles. Free man and slave. Patrician and plebeian. lord and serf, guildmaster and journeyman, in a word, oppressor and oppressed, stood in constant opposition to one another, carried on an interrupted, now hidden, now open flight, a flight that each time ended either in a revolutionary reconstitution of society at large or in the common ruin of the contending classes. In the earlier epochs of history, we find almost everywhere a complicated arrangement of society into various orders, a manifold gradation. Why does that word look so weird to me? I wanted to say graduation at first, just because, you know, but it's the gradation of social rank. In ancient Rome, we have patricians, knights, plebeians, slaves. In the Middle Ages, feudal lords, vassals, guild masters, journeymen, apprentices, serfs. In almost all of these classes, again, subordinate gradations. All right. Sounds pretty good. Oh, to turn off my light. God, look how dark it is without the flashlight. It's crazy.
Dr. Bolpede had done his medical studies quite far from here.
He was in a slaughterhouse.
The first students out of the new campus to settle on the mountainside.
Unknown woman. I never did quite catch her name. The men called her Laura. Lori. She had a neck wound. There was so much blood. The bullet had done a lot of damage, probably hitting the cerebellum. It was hopeless. She had a cardiac arrest. The men had found her like this, they said. I doubt it. But in a small town like this, it's usually best to turn a blind eye. I've been told to step back from sending out the death certificate. This whole thing sickens me.
Doctors used light-reflecting frontal mirrors to look inside the patient's cavity.
Bet they do.
That was a bit unsettling. But back then, it was pretty much always the case with medicine.
Uh-huh. He also used it to look up people's skirts, sicko. Oh, that was where that was. All right. Hey, it's...
the good doctor.
Lady.
Flanked by his beautiful spouse. Pure happiness, captured on cardstock. Carl recognized this woman's soulful eyes. Was it Dr. Beaupré who had hit him head-on at the village border? Nobody kills a rich patient to start a revolution. It didn't make any sense. He had to dig deeper still to understand. Luckily, that was Carl Faubert's specialty.
Oh, he liked getting real deep. A potato? One potato? Oh, all right. I'll allow it.
Someone had lost a few liters of blood here. Carl's first thought had been a lumber accident, someone's hand cut by a saw, or a hunting accident. In any case, whoever had lost all this blood couldn't have gone far. Perhaps they were already dead.
But there's no blood trail of, like, being moved afterwards.
The injured could be recognized by the large stains of red, an informal nickname given to Merbromen, smudged all over their injuries.
Merbromen. Alright, I think we've checked out the majority of this place. I did get that key, now that I think about it. I got a key, and then we found a locked... it was a locked building somewhere on the east side from where we're pointing. It was one of these. Cabin B was locked. I could go back and try to do that. I could do that after I check out all of these, though. Yeah, let's just check that out. Also, didn't I get a treasure map, too? That's probably not in maps. It's probably in, like, specials? Maybe it's a document? Drawing? No. Oh. Just take me back into that. All right. Here's your maps. So it's right next to cabin B. Dang. Maybe we should do it. Because that is where I have the key for, too. God damn it. Let's just do it while we're thinking about it. I know it's a little backtracky, but... Also, let's run around the building like we like to do. Interesting. Got a shitter out here. Somebody likes to drink. One lantern. Something got into his trash. Wolves. God damn it. God damn wolves. I need to follow their footprints at some point.
Great care had to be taken searching this place full of oddities. Everything was important. The decor itself told a story.
Uh-huh. I don't think it does. I don't think you know what you're talking about, narrator. I think you might be the one who drank all that beer. There's an achievement in this for not using the truck outside of the tutorial or the getting to town segment where you were already in the truck. That's pretty rough. Will I get a load somewhere along here? There it is. I want to see what this treasure map is, because I think it might give me a new treasure map every time we go to the spot. And if it leads us back over where we are right now, it's worth getting early, I guess. Is that a little turn right there? I'm gonna check that on the way back, because I didn't see that on the map. Right up here somewhere? I'm going snowblind. I can't see. I feel like we've gone too far. Where was the turn? Oh, God. No. No. We're not ready for this. We went too far. Open the map. Man, it was right after we turned. Should be like right here. I see. And then we ram it. Maybe inside of the treasure hole is a key for cabin B. Good old treasure hole. Alright, so the treasure... be kind of like, whoops, right outside of my... outside of my area. Hitting that button for that. And also the weird giraffe thing. Insane. Alright, so we did not get a key, but I do have a key, so we might as well check it while we're here. I highly doubt it will work, but let's try it anyways. Oh my god, it worked. Wait, this was not the one? Which one was locked? One of these was locked. Solitaire. Only stupid bitches played solitaire. God damn it, narrator man. You make fun of everything I do. Only human trash play solitaire. I guess we'll check this little offshoot building right over here. Beep, 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 beep. Let's just park it. I'll run up the road. It's not like we're gonna freeze to death. Carl's hands were already numb, and his penis was turning black. This wasn't the right one either, I don't think. Oh shit, it was!
Welcome to Alibaba's Cave, Lumberjack what? Edition. Surely Carl would find something worth his time in here.
Like a dead body.
Some nails, some hardware. I can't pick up that lantern, but I can pick up other lanterns. Flares. Welcome to Alibaba's anus. Give me the magnet. What? I can't pick up the magnet. Forest cabin key. Paul and Jean-Pierre, don't forget to return the key for the cabin if you have to use it. Thank you. Your supervisor PS the next bus for Chibaugamau. Be October 12th. Next one is 2 weeks later. Why can't I pick up that magnet? That's bullshit. It would be too cumbersome to carry around. I have become cumbersome. Too rich or too poor, she's wanting me less and I'm wanting more. Sorry, it's a flashback to the 90s. Cumbersome. If I had a hammer, I'd hammer in the morning. Don't need to do hardware with. Need like one wood at a time, if you know what I'm saying. I already got a weird magnet. Maybe that's why it wouldn't let me pick it up. Keep one. Well, we found another key. Can't look at our inventory in here, can we? We can't, no. Because I want to say that treasure went... Can I zoom in? I can't zoom in the car. But I want to say it went up north a bit. Let me look at my inventory in the car. Come on now. I should be able to check my jacket pockets while I'm in here. Treasure maps. Where is number two? Previous next. It is... Oh. Okay. Why do I have a hammer still? I'm pretty sure I put that in the car. actually up here. I don't want to freeze, so I'm just going to drive up. Can I look in the rear view? That's interesting. Are the side mirrors? Nice. Maybe this is it? Hell yeah. That is even further north. And one flare. Do we do this? I think we should drive. Because it is cold. Like, I already cut windows with my hardened diamond nipples, so I don't want to get much colder. Just back up till you wreck. That's how you drive. Treasure maps and cold snaps. Okay. So it was like it was next to a. It's right here. Hold on. Okay, it was right next to this line. Almost exactly. Maybe it was next to the road. Shit. Why won't you just let me look at my inventory, you son of a bitch? So far, it's like my only gripe with the game is that I can't do things when I'm in the truck. No, not letter from Marie. I'm gonna freeze to death out here while I look at my inventory. Wait, that was it. Dang it. Around the bend and up a little bit. Around the bump out. Okay, so it is on that. On that little road. If it's gonna go from one treasure box to the next, though, then it's not gonna go the way of the doctor. Which means kind of just adventuring at this point. And we're gonna have to check this out. Landslide. Whoa, 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 Carl, 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 Carl. Be a bitch. Hello?
The track was fresh. That meant the car sunk down just a little while ago. Now, where the hell could the passengers possibly have gone?
Gotta check out the glove box, dog. Empty? What a baggish.
The crossbow bolts had the same origin. Carl was sure of it. Who was it? And more importantly, what was being hunted like this?
A shoe, a lone boot. Carl's like, nah, dude, I don't need a lone boot.
Carl wondered how long he would have to endure this skin-stinging cold.
What? The manual owner seemed to be Wilfred Roy. We've been to their house, haven't we? They were the family that
got
out of town.
Someone must have in a hurry. But whoever did was heading into the woods. Carl's tracking instincts were quickly kicking in.
Oh wow, I am getting actually cold. Shit. What do you mean throw away? You got off the camera. Oh, there's dog prints. Ghost dog prints. we can't run right now because he's freaking losing his cool. Is there anything along this that we can sit in? Looks like there is. I gotta get there. Should we try to drive? We can't. Yep, won't let us. Alright, well. Since we're cold and there's no fire source around, we're going to go back towards the doctor's place. Keep going that way. Because we don't really have a choice. No, we went that way. We went that way. We went that way. We gotta go back across the bridge. Take a hard right. And then take a hard dump on somebody's, you know. Right in that chamber pot that we saw at the doctor's. You got this, Carl. Just keep, you got it. You don't got it. All right, back up. Oh God. My vision getting blurry because I'm so cold in the car. That's terrible. Truck should have some heat, dude. I mean, turn the heater on. Your truck doesn't have a heater. Oh my God, what is this, the 70s? All right. So we're going, I want to take a right here. The gate open for me, nice. What was that? I think we hit something. Rosary's house. Dude, she's got a nice plate. Oh God, I'm actually freezing, dude. Trucks need heaters, man.
Let me in, ma'am. I'm cold.
Whoa, my banana.
I'm just gonna heat up my rump. Dude, there are people.
Je m'attendais pas à ce qu'un étranger retourne.
Weren't expecting a stranger to show up here. Let me tell ya, I take no chances since the thing's been creeping around. I've got my shotgun in hand all the time. Bang, bang, bang! If it gets too close, right. You need to warm clothes, city boy. I wouldn't say no to a bottle of caribou. Then you pick up whatever rage suits ya. Red caribou for go. I don't have any. Why do I talk like this? Can I steal from you? Hello? The stealing is okay? Everything okay if I steal?
You got to que mon caribou
take your sweet time with my caribou.
Est encore bon.
That's still good. There are so many things better when they're cold. What? This is a gazpacho soup? An empty bottle. I want that coat so bad. You're practically walking around in your underwear, kid. A good coat would be great for you. Let me tell you something. In a place like this, nothing's free. Where's my caribou? I don't know what caribou is, dude. It's aside from booze. Back in my day, it was like that. What we are proud, strong, true. We had a good lord on our side.
Yes,
of course. Nutball, I get it. In the 1917 with a smoke fest, that Kaiser still remembers me. And my shotgun, bang bang, I told him, bang bang bang. The good old days. Do you want me to turn off your music, sir? Look at that sweet rose, let the blue Lola handling herself over to the devil on Ash Wednesday. Terrible, right? What?
Gomme-moi la belle rose de la tulipe.
Handing herself over to the devil. Tales and legends.
Vois-tu le livre, là?
Can you see that book over there? That's the Wendigo. Yeah, Wendigo.
Le Wendigo.
The Wendigo. A warrior who turns into a wolf out of vengeance when they've been wronged. Hey! Okay. There was a time when hate waged war. Our hunters would decimate the great wolves who had taken our children. Our warriors could snap the necks of the cowards who had reached for our supplies. The deafening sound of rock and bone breaking was enough to satiate the hate, and the rivers of blood would express our remorse and apologies. Thus was balance maintained. Then came the whites. Hey, listen up, everyone. I got the crazy guy over here. That's cool. The legend of the Wendigo dates back to the time before what anyone but the tallest trees can remember. A time of great cold and great aspirations when ships came and spewed men in their fire cannons. Plague and spinelessness. Balance broke forever and deads were piling up on our ancestral lands. Too many bodies covered in moss. Too much blood spilled on our stone. Our bone-breaking hate did not suffice any longer. Okay, you're an insane person, and I like it. I'm going to rob you, though. Can't you just have a glass of water or something? Instead of wanting some booze? Ah, the core of you. God damn, that was a wedding fever pass. What? Killed her husband, squick. One after another, no pity for marriage, that one. Ew. Empty. Don't touch that kid, you could hurt yourself. Oh, damn, it's the shitter. Oh, bleh. Oh, he's got a diaper. Yeah, diaper. What? Like you can do everything at the same time? Classic old people. Alright, well, I guess I'll come back with some booze. I had from the good old days in my belt where I put my flask. Things were so much better when we all wore the same thing. Like each other's skin. Look at him opening my shed. Take it, I don't care. Waste your time looking at my trash as long as you bring some caribou. Ho 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 ho. Dude, what a freaking psycho. He's my best friend now. I'm gonna look at him as he takes a dump in his sweet little diaper. Alright. Gotta go dumpster diving real quick. Hells yeah. Excuse me, close the door. Alright. What do we got? Another hatchet. Another gas can. I'm stealing your only ways of chopping wood. No big deal, right, sir? Gas can, hatchet. Interesting. I did not expect to find a man. I thought the whole game was just me. That's awesome. And I have someone to befriend and possibly have sex with, which is, there, like, Carl even better.
But had forgotten the harsh reality that his body also needed nourishment, especially in the dead of winter.
What does that mean?
can make food. Okay. Little wreck, no big deal. So we're just gonna be turning left. I just tried to use the sprint button, but in the car. Like, to make the car sprint. Ow. No big deal. Crystal. God damn it, we gotta check. Where do the footprints go? Forward. God damn it. We should probably wait until we have that coat. What was that? It's a mine entrance? The icy cavern. Holy shit. Alright, we're not gonna go in there. Mainly because it's a cavern and it's gonna be freezing our balls off and we don't have a coat.
You're basically walking around in your underwear, kid.
Don't call me kid, old man. I'll take away your diaper. Wolf prints and crystals. I wonder how long that coat will allow me to stay out. That'll be awesome. That's the place. I guess we'll. House of the Patriot. We'll check his car.
That truck had obviously seen its share of gravel roads. Carl wasn't a mechanic, but he could easily tell that only the most heartfelt prayer would bring this old beater back from its slumber. With that cold, however, it was more likely that it would wait until next spring to wake up.
Dang, I went that way.
With a homemade shooting range such as this, it wasn't hard to imagine a stray bullet ending its course inside the flesh of an unsuspecting passerby. Granted, Carl thought, there wasn't much in the way of passersby around here.
Taking a smoke break while you're on the toilet.
The place looked more like a pigsty than a house. A heavy stench of curdled milk, cheap alcohol, and boiled cauliflower filled the air.
That sounds delicious.
Back then, in Africa and elsewhere, people were ready to take up arms to stand against the yoke of English imperialism. In Montreal, mailboxes were blown up, abductions were carried out, and violent manifestos were distributed to media outlets. But around here, in the great northernmost, all a man could do is curse out loud against the faraway evil and pray for the revolution to arise.
Evil!
That man, by any reckoning, was from that very stock. Rock music invaded the minds of men even in the remotest of places. The man didn't own a turntable though, so there's that going for him.
Why wash dishes when clean ones are within reach? Good call.
Today, Jean Blouin, seems like that pig had a name after all.
That pig. Wow, so judgmental, Carl.
Looks like he's living in a pigsty.
Carl now knew how to quench the drunkard's thirst.
Caribou traditional recipe. White whiskey, sherry wine, spices.
The rag reeked of fermented vomit.
Okay.
Carl wondered how one could bear to live in such gross and horrid conditions.
Yeah, that's a little on the weird side. Drawers are overrated when you can just put it on the ground. Prepare the caribou. Well, I don't have the stuff.
Carl knew right away that the owner of this place wasn't a copper collector. No, this was a junkman's base of operations. The guy definitely seemed like quite the expert in scavenging scrap metal, with or without permission, surely. In the right hands, red metal could sell like hotcakes.
Don't call me Shirley.
You had to be out of your mind to cook up white whiskey at home. The all-surrounding stench of alcohol alone was probably enough to gas a man to death.
A gun rack. I think the only thing I have out in the truck is one beer, so that's not gonna do me any good. Alright. Nothing. Nothing in the booze-making department. Interesting. Well, I guess we're on our way again. Ooh, maybe there's the stuff in the, general store to make the booze. A beer bottle, but no beer. Just the bottle. Guess I didn't check behind the range. I highly doubt there is anything there, but let's look.
If Carl had at any point wished to get his hands on some caribou, he couldn't have wished for better than a distillery like this one.
It's just, heat up real quick. We're good. Let's leave the door open because we're terrible people. We've got like, what, one or two places around this outer area. To look. And I do think we'll probably have to check the store for caribou items. Oh god. Okay. It's wrecked. That's the cave. Oops. We have to get the coat and then we can really explore the crystals and tracks and all that business. And where that car was with all the strewn clothing as well.
Sometimes, and especially around here, people are so possessive with their land as a dog is with hydrants.
Dear Mr. Lamoth, here is the spark plug you ordered for your Olympic ski-doo. This model being very popular has made it difficult to find a brand new partner as quickly as usual. Thank you for choosing the garage, blah, blah, blah. Sincerely, blah, 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 blah. Can I actually take it? I did. Nice. One spark plug. Yep. Prince going that way. What a shock. Moth's garage. Okay.
Another worrisome victim of this ice. This one seemingly petrified in action. The poor man, before being frozen solid, seemed to have been defending the entrance to his cabin.
But
from what?
What's he doing? Looking at something. He's making a... What the shit? What? Out a flashlight. Am I stuck? Normally there's something to click on that, how do I get up there, though?
Something very important must have been in there for the man to take such time and effort to hide it. But Carl didn't know how to reach it.
Is there a fireplace in here? Or are we just gonna get cold? Some pliers. Is he working on this radio? No. Right. What the hell is it? Huge? No. H-U-I-L-E? I don't know what that says. Something. Huge dicks. Sometimes something isn't right when your bed is in your garage.
The very first steps of man on the moon were made more than a year ago. The event had surely captivated the mechanic's mind for him to still keep this around.
Yeah, well, it looked like he's, building something. And I'm going to save it to look at last, because it's highly arousing. Unused steel trap, not to be touched. Carl slapped his dick into it. Alright, let's look at this spaceship in a second.
The week of October 5th, thought Carl. That was this week. The plug should have been here by now.
It is. I have it in my inventory. Repair the spaceship. He's an astronaut. Uh-oh.
It was an indisputable fact that machines like this entailed a level of intellectual finesse that Carl was lacking.
Homemade flying saucer. Life never ceases to amaze me. I got a headlight, though. Alright, how do we get stuff out of the bucket? Goes outside. Should I take a dick pic of this guy? I think I should. I wonder if I should take a picture of the saucer. No. Game's like, nah, that's shit. There's a hole on the roof. There's an A-hole on the roof, too. No Bigfoot in the shitter.
Perhaps someone was expecting an important call. In any case,
painkillers.
Carl already noticed that telephone services weren't provided in this area. The milk was sorted by color, from the whitest to the greenest.
That's racist.
Words, from the freshest to the sourest.
Got a snowmobile ski. Hamilton, I won't be your dog anymore. Be whatever I want you to be, you sick mother. Heater? Is there a heater in here? No heater? What kind of hotel is this? Blueprints for a
if
weird
some
spaceship.
Some daring person could manage to get their hands on the missing parts. Carl was willing to bet that the craft would have taken flight.
But it didn't. It blew up. You were already there. Ooh. Cheap wine doesn't taste better, even if it changes in color and size. Aw, I can't get the one I want for that booze man. Apparently, Lamoth is a rock collector. Okay. At least he sorts things. Dang it, empty.
These scribblings were undoubtedly the mark of a tormented mind. Something wasn't right in the poor mechanic's head.
Hi-o. Seems like things were very right. Vampires? Garlic to repel vampires or else? When one isn't enough, why not buy eight? Apple Jacks? Apple Juices? Apple Jacques.
The man has a passion for intergalactic things. Back then, people were obviously scared of the Russian atomic bomb, but an invasion by extraterrestrials was a legit fear as well. Seems like the mechanic had made his choice.
Dear Mr. Lamoth, following
Roswell,
up on your...
Atamipek, same story. Large deserts conducive to extravagant follies.
Following up on your complaint, I'm afraid that the police cannot support your claim alleging the sudden appearances of a man who came from outer space on your village's territory. Manifestly, what happened at Roswell in New Mexico left a deep impression on you, and we would urge you to consult with a physician as soon as possible regarding future potential complaints. Let it be known that the judicial district of Abitabai does not believe in little green men. Wow, these people are all kind of a-holes.
Oh hell, what? Look at that! Freaking fire. What a shock.
Carl deducted this was a map of the area. Were those pins pointing to places of interest?
Oh. Okay. Wonder if he marked them on the map. That'd be nice if he did.
Weird stuff. Kind of a crossing between a colander and a hairdryer. What was it for? To play telepath? To protect against nuclear waves?
Yep. Suspension is when Mart's taking the puzzle apart is easy. Putting it back together is another story. I patched everything up with the tracks. I left it close by. Skis don't drink with work. Don't drink at work. Don't drink at work. I'm misplacing parts of the machine. Regine came to help me work on the machine yesterday afternoon. For the most part, he helped me chug my bottles down to the last drop. I think we tried to ski or something. Bad idea. I still haven't found that one ski we lost in the process. All right, let's look in our inventory. Spark plug. Headlight, one ski mobile ski. Forest cabin. Dun 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 dun. Okay. Whoop. Not done yet. Z is my previous section. Okay, yeah, we looked at that. Watched that, we saw that. These ones were new. File seems incomplete. Who is the Cree woman and what happened to her? Everything points to a certain death, but no death certificate. I'm no doctor, but I know fresh blood when I see it. Someone bled profusely on the office less than 2 days ago. Nothing weird about that unless... I need to head north. My investigation will not be complete without taking a look at Hamilton's Lodge, but the road is caved in. I can't really picture myself walking all these miles. I need a warm coat, essential. Guns and ammunition can't be too careful. Proper mode of transportation, vital. Find out how to get rid of the big wall of ice that came out of nowhere. What? I met an old man. He wants some drinkies. Something in his mail? Didn't I? I got the spark plug out of his mailbox, I think. And then we found another arrow. Not too far north from the landslide. Okay. Like section C? Ah, it's just the dudes. Gotcha. Okay. And then did he mark any of these things on the map? He did. Secret project. A cave? Yeah, we did not find the cave next to the general store. The ice cave we did find. That's really far to run in the snow. Would love to get the booze to that dude. I think I should go check the general store. We'll look around right out here just to see if there's anything of interest, like this car. Hell yeah! Snowmobile ski, dude!
What good was a motorless car? The mechanic sure had an odd way to go about repairing things.
Gotta check in his trash. Still didn't figure out how to get the thing on his roof either. There's trash down there. Carl loves trash. He's basically Oscar the Grouch. Wait. Oscar the Grouch? Yeah, he was the I Love Trash guy. Been a long time since I Sesame Streeted, so, you know. A bench?
Carl hadn't lived up to his good finder reputation. He still hadn't found any of the wealth contained in Lamotte's lands.
Mowing the lawn is unnecessary this time.
By following the plan, Carl was led to believe that the snowmobile's parts had to be scattered about in the vicinity.
I saw the handles inside, didn't I? Pretty sure I did. Fill up the gas can. I'm like 100% that I saw the handlebar or the handles somewhere. Let me just toast up my rumples. Ooh, nice toasty rump. They must have been out in the shed. I saw them. Or the barn or whatever it was. Check out this truck? I don't think we did.
Well, this truck's not going anywhere. Where were the amputated parts? Carl grinned as he pictured a Frankenstein-esque car lying around somewhere made of parts from a dozen different vehicles.
Too many orange juice bottles. No, there's never enough orange juice. There they are. I knew I saw them somewhere. Handlebars, headlights. A track. Okay, we have not seen a track. I don't think. Oh. Well, F. Skis.
A bit of gas, a new spark plug, and a key. And this thing would run perfectly.
A key?
All he needed to do now was to...
That's what's in the bucket that the guy threw. That's what it is. It's a key. It's gotta be. I got gas in the car. I've got gas in my anus, really. It's in my guts. And, been consuming a lot of beans. Can I unlock it from this side? I'm guessing it's locked. Shitballs. Maybe I need to clip it with my clippers. Excuse me? How dare you? Let's take out an empty. Empty. Wait, no. We want to take one empty gas can. Want to put in anything? I can't jump it, can we? No. Can we clip the fence? Super can. It would just break everything. Carl let himself into every place he wanted to go because he's a super badass. Well, he's an ass.
Sheets of metal everywhere. Was Carl out of touch with current home improvement trends? Or perhaps this was meant to protect against residual radiation? Gamma rays?
Alright, so I need... I thought I saw a dot. I didn't think Carl could climb. How in the actual balls? I'm not allowed to jump in here? That is weird. got smoke from that. Can I throw something up there, maybe? Potato? I was thinking I could use like a magnet thing, but... I feel like I have to get on the roof for that, right? And then I drop my little magnet on a string down. I feel like I'm gonna freeze to death trying to do it, though. I also can't jump high enough. You know what I'm saying? Like, that seems like it might be the thing, but... I kinda don't think so, but it seems like the only option. That stuff doesn't quite go high enough. Yeah, Carl, I know. Warm yourself up for just a moment. There's gotta be a way to get up there.
Weird stuff.
I can't
kind of a
jump that
between
high.
A colander and a hairdryer. What was it for?
I'm a white
to
man.
Play telepath?
I can't jump.
To protect against nuclear waves?
Well, maybe we're gonna have to go check out, like... secret project or something. Maybe there's got to be something that lets us get up there, but I don't see what or how. But I think we'll save that for next time, and I'll thank you guys for watching, and we'll see you next time for more Kona.